Alright, Shalom, let us continue. Okay, so we had to pause that video because we kind of had something in mind, but it just kind of like, you know, come up with clouds, it kind of clouded up. But nonetheless, this that we speak is very clear, very obvious, but to some it comes with clouds, blurriness. And this is the twofold, this is judgment within itself, you know. Nobody wants to hear that Christ is a black man. Why? Because they're so... Because then they have to accept that they've been deceived. Nobody wants to accept Ethiopia to be the kingdom of God upon earth. Why? Because then they're going to have to deal with the fact that they may very well be racist, or may very well be prejudiced, or why them? Why Ethiopia? Why black people? Why this? Why that? But just unable to conform to the truth. So they rather stick with their religions and not have to accept the judgment. You know, Christ, yes, as he cometh with grace and you know, proclaiming the acceptable day of the Lord, but our Father, Majesty, Most High, he cometh with judgments, you know. You're going to accept this to be what it can only be, or you're going to prove yourselves to be like the slanderer, like the deceiver, Satan himself, the serpent, you know, that old-time dragon, since the beginning, kind of hating on Christ, on Adam and stuff like that. Like, nah, why him? Why man? Why that? You know, just bitching about it and not accepting things to be what they are. So we were trying to, alright, so we were saying how, you know, to some people, it's very clear. Why? Because chapter 5, the Gospel of St. Matthew, verse 2, and he opened his mouth and taught them, saying, to whom? To his disciples. Because once he was up on a mountain, and he was set, replaced by the oncoming generation, his disciples came to him. His disciples, those willing, that made the efforts and separated out into the wilderness and then went up into a mountain, into a higher state of mind. To them, he opened his mouth, but to others, he opened not his mouth. So to some, he cometh with clouds, and to others, he cometh with fire, with judgment, you know? And so now, there are some other scriptures that it are related to this. Okay. Why does he speak in parables? Because to you it is given. To the disciples it is given. You know? Come out of her, my people. Come out of this religious confusion and accept the truth. And it might just very well be given to you. To whom is it given? Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. You know? So, this is really... We give thanks to the Most High that we're... You know, that we've been given this, but we too would like to share this with all. So now, you know, so Israel, hoy, Shema Israel, listen, escucha. Now, also, for some reason, because this is all concerning Torah portion, Orit Nebab number 17, Jethro, Yithro, Yotor, and Psalm 72, a description of the kingdom. You know, Psalm 72 ends with these words, and Psalm 72 is los y delante él se postrarán los etíopes y sus enemigos lamerán la tierra. Befitum Ethiopia y Sigdalu telat ochum afer yilsal. You know, King James Version it reads, and they that dwell in the wilderness shall bow before him. But truly it should be read, and Ethiopia shall bow before him, and his enemies shall lick the dust. You know, so Psalm 72, and that psalm, it ends with a, excuse me, so, you know, we're repeating some of this knowledge, but it's so that we could actually become learned in it. So the Psalm 72, give the king thy judgments, O God, and righteousness to the king's son. We've been through so many different verses that clearly describe the fullness of that. But what we seek to bring forth in this particular moment is this ends with Psalm 72 ends with verse 20 that reads, the prayers of David, the son of Jesse, are ended, fulfilled. You know, I'm lucky, my God, and then, you know, it is done, it is finished. So, the book of 2 Samuel, the last words of David, which is chapter 23, reads, "Now these be the last words of David, David the son of Jesse, said, and the man who was raised up on high, the anointed of God, the anointed of the God of Jacob, and the sweet psalmist of Israel, said, the Spirit of the Lord spake by me, and his word was in my tongue. The God of Israel said, the Rock of Israel spake to me. He that ruleth over men must be just, ruling in the fear of God. Only one ruleth in the fear of God, and that is his Imperial Majesty, the mighty Trinity. And he shall be as the light of the morning, ushering in this new day, this kingdom age. You know, today is a new day. You know, going forward, says his Imperial Majesty, May 5th, 1941, Ethiopia Victory Day. And so, going forward, when the sun rises, even a morning without clouds. To us, without clouds. He cometh with clouds, you know, like lightning strike. So is the Spirit of His Majesty stricken upon I and I that have been able to be pierced in our hearts with that lightning, with that spirit, you know, that quickeneth from the east to the west. So, going forward, this is what we were looking for. Even a morning without clouds. To Rastafari, it's without clouds. To us, it's been given, and to other people, you know, they just want to rather pretend that it's not so, because they want to stick to grace and you know, the acceptable year of the Lord, but they don't want to take on judgment and really, you know, purify, test your heart with fire. Are you going to accept that which is, or are you going to just pretend that it's not, you know? And so, what a magnificent way to test the hearts, you know? Now, going forward, it reads, as the tender grass springing out of the earth by clear shining after rain, although my house be not so with God, yet he hath made with me an everlasting covenant, ordered in all things, and sure, for this is all my salvation and all my desire, although he make it not to grow. But the sons of Belial shall be all of them as thorns thrust away, because they cannot be taken with ends. But the man that shall touch them must be fenced with iron and the staff of a spear, and they shall be utterly burned with fire in the same place. So now, let us continue on with this reasoning. Now, we'll go forward to the book of Acts, chapter 1. And it's verse 7 and 6 we have written down in our notes. Let's see what that has to do with, about, you know. And he said to them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father hath put in his own power. So, once again, judgment, vengeance, in the power of the Trinity, which is Haile Selassie first, God the Father, and Christ in his kingly character. And there are other things in the power of the Son, you know, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord, to come in grace, to proclaim, declare liberty, you know, in all them descriptions as a sacrifice. One bear the burden upon his shoulder of government, which is his Imperial Majesty, and the Son bore the cross of sacrifice upon his shoulder, you know, righteousness allotted to the Son, to the King's Son. You know, what is his name? His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie first, elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings of Ethiopia, Rastafari. What is his son's name? Get Achina, Methanet Achin Jesus Christos, Yeshua HaMashiach, you know, Bein Ha Elohim. You know, a rod shall spring forth out of the stem of Jesse. What is that rod? Get Achin Jesus Christos. That stem is the circumcision from all flesh, being born of the Spirit of God Almighty, the Holy Spirit. And what is the root? from which cometh the branch. It is I and I as Rastafari. You know, the root being the nourisher, the feeder, the sustainer. The root of David, Haile Selassie first. The conquering line of the tribe of Judah prevaileth. And what is the branch? The branches are we. We are told so in the New Testament by Iyesus the Christ, that we are the branches, and he is the vine, and without him we can do nothing. And the leaves, you know, Revelations, somewhere around chapter 21 or 22, it goes into the healing of the nations. We are the healing of the nations. We bring forth that light. We are the light. We illuminate the people with the truth. And you know, I fully get the multitudes out of religious confusion and apostasy and stuff like that. Why? Because the root is Haile Selassie first, sustain us since the foundations. The stem, the rod, is Yesus Christos, and we are the branches that bear fruit. You know, our leaves, you know, do feed the multitudes. If ones know anything about trees and stuff like that, plants, what? Okay, the nourisher, the sustainer, are the roots. The stem is the way that in which there is communication from the root to the branches. The branches, they stretch forth their hands and receive the light, and the light therefore goes through. It is filtered through the stem, and it is sent to the root so that it with the process of photosynthesis can be in turn renewed and used accordingly to sustain the plant. And that plant doth bear fruit as we Rastafari, you know, do bring forth this abundant fruit of truth and right, you know, and justice to all humanity without no regard to sex or race or religion or color or all that nonsense, you know. And so going forward, some things in the power of the Father, other things in the power of the Son, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Spirit is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses to me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and to the uttermost part of the earth. And this scripture this day is fulfilled within the eyes of and ears of them that, you know, happen to watch this video. So, but going forward, you know, if that's not enough, we'll keep bringing forth the evidence. So now, with that, let us go on to John. Let us not, because actually John, all over John, Jesus the Christ is declaring the Father. You know, Father, keep them that you have given me in your name. Father, I don't pray for the world, but I pray for these that you have given me. You know, I go to the Father. The Father is mightier than I. The Father, the Father, the Father. How can one pretend that Christ, it will be made manifest as the Son? It's illogical. It's wrong. In the beginning was the Word, the Logos, the reason, the logic, and that fallacy is not credible. But the truth of Rastafari is sure and full and truth and correct and exact. You know? So even we've heard Hebrew Israelites that don't believe in the Trinity. Well, how do you explain? You can't. You have to accept it. It's not, you know, forgive those Christians which have done so much wrong in the name of Christ, wrongfully, ignorantly, we pray. And we hope not maliciously, but still, you know, because they've corrupted the name of the Son, Jesus the Christ, you know, receive the Father, you know, Rastafari. Because we come into in a new name. Why? Because that his name has been daily corrupted. But Rastafari, keep it true. You know, we are them who have been given to Jesus the Christ. You know, and kept in the Father's name. Why? Because we are called of the Father's Majesty Most High, and then we are told to worship the Son. And the Son saith, thou art I and thy brothers, you know, thou art I, my brothers. And so we serve our brother, you know. And so we go forward. So we're not going to go, basically what we're trying to say is we're not going to go to John, because all over the Gospel of St. John, it is testified to Jesus testifying to himself and the Father, you know. So we'll conclude with the book of Hebrews. in case it couldn't be any more clear. Chapter 9. Verse 25. The one sacrifice of the new covenant is better than the many sacrifices of the old, is the title, you know. Now, nor yet that he should offer himself often. As the high priest entereth into the holy place every year with blood of others. We give abundant thanks because this just came to mind. If the world continues believing, if the world believes in this false doctrine in which this lie, in which the same Christ that they think is the Christ, which is not even the Christ, you know, will come exactly the way that he came to fulfill the role and responsibility and character of the Son. Once again, nor yet that he should offer himself often. Once does Christ be manifested as our sacrifice, carrying upon his shoulder the burden of the cross. Only once, not often. For once is perfect in Christ Jesus to be the sacrifice, ultimate sacrifice, for the redemption of I and I. You know, Jah people. How can one expect them to be sacrificed often? Not so. Jah come in the form of Christ in his kingly character, God the Father in glory, you know? So now going forward it reads, for then must he often have suffered since the foundation of the world. But now once in the end of the world that he appeared to put away sin by the sacrifice of himself, once again, righteousness given to the Son, to the King's Son, excuse me. This fulfilled in Yeshua HaMashiach. And now we have verse 27. And as it is appointed to men once to die, but after this the judgment. Judgment. To whom hath judgment been allotted to? To whom is the power of judgment given to? To his Imperial Majesty. To whom is vengeance, the power of vengeance given to God the Father, his Majesty Most High? You know, the King. Rastafari. Verse 28, so Christ was once offered to bear the sins of many that cross, to whom was carried the burden of government upon his shoulder, his Majesty, that great counselor, the everlasting Father, you know, the Prince of Peace, so now, going, earth rightful ruler, the light of this world. So now going forward it reads, and to them that look for him, shall he appear the second time without sin to salvation. Very, very clear, you know, to those that desire him, that bring a judgment, his Majesty. Those that look for him, don't expect no white, fake Jesus or Jesus, white Christ imposter to knock on your door and say, you know, I'm back. To those that look for him, and with a pure heart, if it be who it be, then it be who it be, and it could be nobody else than he who fulfilled all prophecy and scripture, and the word of the Almighty, his Majesty, Abba John Hutt, our Father Majesty, Rastafari, his Imperial Majesty, Ali Selassie first, elect of God, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings of Ethiopia. So now, you know, even within Hebrews, there's another verse that reads on, you know, why would Christ Jesus speak about another day, you know, if there would be no need for another day to be made manifest. And we'll just conclude with we'll see if we can find this. We read this not too long ago. It's the book of Hebrews has to do with the angels. And it has to do with, like, four put subject. Okay, so we'll actually pause right there because we wish to take the eyes time no longer. But basically what we can Rastafari, you know? Just listen, less truth were to slip your hands, you know, less it were to salvation were to pass you by, you know. Don't let, you know, listen to all spirits, and he that do testify that Jesus is the Son of God that came in the flesh, will always be of Jah, Rastafari of God, you know. So we'll pause right there. You know, forgive me for not actually being able to find that scripture, but it's within Hebrew, so we give thanks to all. Shalom, Rastafari.